The landing on Kyushu was scheduled for, I think it was November 1st, 1945. And we were supposed to, they were going to take about half of Kyushu and establish, that's the southernmost island of the Japanese chain. And they were going to then establish air bases to then make the landing on Honshu, the big island. But so since when the Japanese surrendered, they sent us and the 25th Division into Nagoya, and we had to wait after we got up there. We had to anchor and wait for a couple of weeks until the Navy got into Nagoya Harbor with minesweepers, because they had pretty heavily mined the harbor. And then I was sent down to the mouth of Nagoya, the Nagoya Bay there, with a company of the 25th Infantry, and they were dismantling. There were gun emplacements all around the harbor there, and they were bringing this ammunition down to the beach, and then we load it on our boats and take it out through the minefields and dump it out in the ocean.
Yeah, there was no fighting then.
No.
It was like cleaning up.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So actually you were in Japan until they sent your, did they send your unit home or what?
No, we went home based on the point system, and I had enough points to leave there in just before Christmas of 1945.
And did you have to have a replacement, or did you just went home because of the point?
Yeah.
Points.
Yeah. Actually, I think the unit was dismantled sometime after that. It just kept getting smaller and smaller.
And so, when you came home, how did you get, did you fly back?
No, I came home on
a ship.
There was, they had just launched some new class of troop carriers that carried about 5,000. Are you familiar with them?
No, but I've heard about them.
And I was on one called the Admiral Rodman, which was brand new. And it took us from, we didn't go home from Nagoya. I think we went home from Tokyo, come to think about it. I know we went on a train up some distance and then got on this troop carrier. Mm-hmm. And we went to San Diego.
Oh, and what year was, what's the date of this?
That would have been early in January of 46. Uh-huh. And we went to some base there, and we were there 2 or 3 days and turned in a lot of our uniform stuff and got a shave and a haircut and a steak dinner.
In San Francisco?
No, in San Diego.
San Diego.
Yeah. I remember they had German POWs serving the steak dinner.
And so you went home from San Diego?
Well, I went to Fort Sheridan, Illinois, and by train, mm-hmm. and then took the then I went up to Milwaukee and flew across the lake to Muskegon, mm-hmm. and then I was home. So.
And I'm sure that your family gave you a big welcome.
Yeah. Well, we had Christmas. As I say, my brother got home about 3 weeks after I did. So then we had our Christmas in January.
Uh-huh. So. Just before we go further, what did it feel like being a young man away from home in the South Pacific during that period of time? Did you, was it kind of unique feeling, or did you feel lonely? Or?